Stefan, is youth employment the next big thing in rural development?
We have to clearly see that, in particular in Africa, we will have about 440 million young people entering the labor market by 2030. So that means this is 30 million people, young people, each and every year, and the majority of them in rural areas. We cannot ignore that. If high rates of youth unemployment, poverty and hunger, environmental degradation and climate shocks come together, we will see conflicts, terrorism, and more forced migration be on the rise, and that is simply not acceptable.
What is the BMZ doing in that regard?
We did this year launch a G20 Rural Youth Employment Initiative. So that is the first good news. We do not stay on our own. There is now a broad coalition saying, okay, this is an important issue and we have to address this jointly. In our cooperation programs in agriculture, in rural development, in food security, we will from now on give special attention to the youth employment issue. Each and everywhere we ask, okay, what can we do within these projects really to increase employment and to provide new job opportunities. First and foremost, that will happen within the agricultural sector. But if you see, for example, in soil conservation or in forest restoration, there are huge opportunities for public works programs. And in the longer run, every euro invested today in food security of young people, of young children, and in sustainability of natural resources will pay off 3, 4, and 10 times in the near future.
What about the sheer number of people? Do we have to start talking about family planning now in development cooperation?
Family planning will come automatically. Once people see opportunities for a better living, for better livelihoods in rural areas, if they get more and more in contact with modern life, family planning will be on the rise. We see it already in many countries, and those who are still lagging behind will enter on this path in a very near future. I am absolutely convinced.
Youth employment has a lot to do with aspirations of young people, actually, and what actually pulls them away from the rural areas into the cities. And that obviously has a lot to do with communications. What are the opportunities that lie in modern communications from your perspective?
In the end, it's always a mix of hard factors and soft factors. Of course, you need real job opportunities, but at the same time, it must make fun. And so there you need entertainment opportunities in the rural areas, opportunities to have a great leisure time. And this is based on soft facts, but also on communication. And finally, I mean, closing the gap between urban life and rural life also means promoting more virtual links. We have the opportunities now via internet really to link people, to bring people together that they can feel, okay, we are living in a global village, not just in our small village. And once we succeed in making that step, I think there is a great opportunity that people think, well, it's great to live here. It's fun to live here, and it has advantages, and it's an asset to live here. Yeah. So fresh air and fresh minds for the countryside.